My name is Dwayne Lard, and I teach construction technology at Crockett High School and also at ACC. The course I'm teaching right now is called Methods and Materials. We do a lot of different things in there, and this series is designed to eventually be cutting rafters and cutting in stairs. So the first thing we'll talk about today is converting from the architectural scale, which is feet and inches and then parts of an inch, down to a 16th, and converting those numbers, that's the architectural scale, into the engineer scale, which is feet and then decimal place and then parts of a foot. As you may or may not know, the decimal system is so much easier to work in as opposed to the architectural scale when we're talking about multiplying and adding and subtracting. So we're going to go ahead and show you how to convert from the architectural scale to the engineer scale initially. So these are two leveling rods, and on the left, you can see it goes in between 3 feet and 4 feet. It goes up in between 3 feet and 4 feet. It goes up in twelfths or inches. Okay. So this is the scale that the architects use. They use feet and inches and then parts of an inch. This is called the engineer scale, because it is divided, if you notice, the distance between the feet is exactly the same on both scales. The difference is there are 10 parts in between feet on the engineer scale. On the architecture scale, there is 12. But there is, just for example, if we look at 6 inches on the architecture scale, then it is 3.5 on the engineer scale. That's how it translates. So even if it was, 3'7½", then there is a corresponding part directly across here that is exactly the same distance off of the floor in this case. So that's how we translate from the architectural scale, which is in inches, feet, and inches, to the engineer scale, which is feet, and then parts of the foot in tenths. So when we're dealing with the architectural scale, you're going to have, for example, 17 feet, 5½ inches. The first thing we have to do is we have to convert this parts of 1 inch, in this case it's a half, we have to convert this into the decimal system. The way that we do that, and here is a visual cue, this is kind of a memory tool that I use. When I see this, this is the operation division that I'm going to be using the entire time to convert from the architectural scale all the way down to the engineer scale. Most of you recognize this is since 1 divided by 2, and this equals to 0.5 in this case, the engineer scale. So what we'll do is, anytime you see a fraction like this, let's go 5/8. All this means is 5 divided by 8. I don't have that off. I think it's 0.625 if I'm not mistaken. We'll check that and edit it out later if we need to. So whenever you see a fraction, the first thing you want to do is when you convert it into the engineer scale, then you take the numerator, the top number, and divide it by the bottom number, and that will give you a decimal point and then the numbers behind it. This and this are exactly equal. This is the architectural scale. This is the engineer scale. Next step of this is we will add a whole number to this. That's going to equal 0.625. Now I converted that into feet. Okay? So keep in mind, when I'm converting this entire situation, when I'm going from the architectural scale into the engineer scale, The method of the operation that I'm going to be using is always going to be division, because this is my memory tool. 1/2, okay, is the fraction. So that's the next step. The first step is to convert the parts of an inch, and then we can convert the parts of a foot in inches, and then we're going to go ahead and add something to this. because most of your dimensions when you're building a house are going to be in feet and inches. So let's do this. So we have 17 feet, 8, and 9 sixteenths inches. Okay? So this is a full architectural scale. What I'm going to do is I'm going to convert this into the engineer scale. Step one is to take 9 divided by 16. And I've got my 9 divided by 16 equals 17 feet, 8.5625 inches. Okay? So now I want to further convert this into just feet and then parts of a foot represented in the engineer scale. I will take this number, and since there's 12 parts to a foot, I'm going to take the 8.5625 and divide that by 12, and that will give me 17.7135.4167 feet, okay? So I've converted my architectural scale, 17 feet, 8 and 9 sixteenths inches, into the engineer scale. Now, this is a very long number. I like to go ahead and be accurate up to 4 decimal places. Here's 5. So the rule of rounding is you take this number. If I want to round to this number, I'm going to take the first number to the right, and if it's 5 or above, then I'm going to add 1. Well, since it's below 5, then I'm going to leave that alone. So, that's how you convert from the architectural scale to the engineer scale. This is something that you can do on your own. You can just make up, I just made these numbers up. You can make your own numbers up anytime you want to, and then just go through the process. But the engineers use it because it's so much easier to multiply 17.392 feet times 3.91 feet rather than 17 feet, 3 and 9 sixteenths inches times 3 foot, 11 and 5/8 inches. So I could do this, but it's really long and complicated. This is so much easier to do, and once you do this mathematics, you crunch the numbers, and then you'll convert from the engineer scale back to the architectural scale.
How do you convert back?
That's a great question. So now, converting from the engineer scale to the architectural scale. Let's go ahead and do this one. So, the memory tools that I used for from architectural to engineering is 1/2, and my memory tool was division. So that means whenever I'm going through this process, every step of the way, I'm going to be using division. Okay, so my memory tool here is this little dot. If you remember back to your algebra, 2 times 3. Equals 6, and this little that dot right there represents multiplication. So that means this memory tool says I'm going to start with multiplying to convert this to the architectural scale, and I'm going to stay with the multiplication all the way through the process. So the way that this looks is, and this is kind of a side note, but you always want to pay attention to this right up here. The way this stands for feet, so feet, and then inches, two syllables. Okay. This is going to tell you where you're going to start. If you're starting with feet, or you're starting it with inches, it's going to make a difference. If you're starting with feet, which we are right here, is you're going to not do anything to the 17 feet. You have 17 complete feet. So what we're doing is we're taking everything to the right of the decimal place. This is all part of 1 foot. It's 17 plus something here, and we don't know what it is yet. So since we're in feet, we're first going to multiply by 12, which is the number of parts of a foot. And we're multiplying not the 17, but just everything to the right of the decimal place. And that's going to give me 4.7052, okay? So now this tells me that I've got 17 feet, and now I've got 4.7052 inches. 0.3921 is 4 inches plus this part right here. So now I've got 4 complete inches, and now everything to the right of my decimal place is parts of an inch. And so now in construction, typically the smallest division of an inch that we go to is going to be a 16th. We'll take our everything to the right of the decimal place and multiply that times 16, which is the parts, the number of parts of an inch. We have 11.2832. And since we've used 16ths, we're trying to find out how many 0.7052 parts of 1 inch are in 16ths. This answer is going to be in 16ths. And now we go to the rounding situation. Everything to, if we want to round to this place right here, then we go to one place to the right, and if it's 5 or above, then we'll add 1 to it, to the next number to the left. If it's below 5, then we'll just leave it alone. In this case, we don't mess with it, 0.2832, and now we have 11 sixteenths inches. So, there you have it.